when you look at the graph, you put norepinephrine initially. Norepinephrine is a vasoconstrictor, so the blood flow is going to decrease a little bit, right? Okay, so now when you remove the stellate ganglion, you're doing a sympathectomy, so no longer there's a sympathetic drive to the blood vessels.
Hey guys, so this is the graph that I had shown you. So now look at the x-axis, which is the time in weeks, and the y-axis, which is the blood flow. Okay, so the volume of blood flow, in a sense, it is about the rate of blood flow. Okay, right. So what happens here is there is stellate ganglionectomy that is being done, right? So what happens before and after that? Now, before that, what happens? This is the normal stage where if you put a norepinephrine, okay, if you give norepinephrine, there is going to be vasoconstriction and a decrease in the blood flow, all right? Now, after you do a stellate ganglionectomy, what happens is there is a rise in the blood flow. Why?
So now the intrinsic vascular tone decreases, there is vasodilatation, and there's a lot of blood flow, okay? So there's a blood flow increase. And eventually what happens, there is going to be denervation, hypersensitivity, there's going to be upregulation of these sympathetic receptors. So now what happens, the vascular tone is going to increase. So there is going to be vasoconstriction. So then naturally the blood flow keeps decreasing. Can you see that it plateaus off? Okay, so it plateaus off. And now when you put norepinephrine, after this denervation, hypersensitivity, the receptors are upregulated. They are extremely sensitive to norepinephrine. So they vasoconstrict like never before. So the drop in the blood flow is much more than the previous one. So that explains the entire graph. Do you understand? So that is denervation, hypersensitivity, because of upregulation of the receptors.
So stellate ganglionectomy is equivalent to what we call a sympathectomy. So there is a loss of intrinsic vascular tone, there is an increase in blood flow, but subsequently what happens is you get getting a denervation, hypersensitivity, and an increased response to norepinephrine. I hope you understood the graph. So this graph is best explaining denervation, hypersensitivity. All right.
So the same concept is used in the diagnosis of Aedes pupil, where we are using a very dilute concentration of pilocarpine, and number two, in the diagnosis of Ohnner syndrome, where we are using 1% apraclonidine because the alpha 1 receptors have been upregulated. All right. So this is about denervation, hypersensitivity, and its clinical application in ophthalmology.